And now it's time for Top 5 with your host, the guy who's on the screen right now.
Hi. You know, a friend of mine recently asked me a question. A question that was so brilliant, I can't believe I didn't think of it myself. If you could own the entire film collection of any two actors, which actors would you choose? Now, this is a difficult question. It's not just who your favorite actor is, but whose body of work has the greatest diversity and entertainment value. Well, I thought about it long and hard, and I've come up with my first choice. Nicolas Cage. Ta-da! Is there any other actor quite as polarizing as Nick Cage? It really does appear as if you either love him or you hate him, and it's easy to understand why. Half the time, he's delivering Oscar-worthy performances with great character depth in films that are generally highly entertaining. Other times, it appears as if we're watching a man slowly go insane on film. But every time, and I do mean every time, even in the worst movies, Nicolas Cage is entertaining to watch. And perhaps there is no other actor with quite as much balls as Nicolas Cage. So here today, we are counting down the top 5 Nick Cagiest Nick Cage films. These are not the best Nick Cage films. These are not the worst Nicolas Cage films. These are the films that I put in whenever I need a fix. And the only prescription is Nicolas Cage.
Can I get my prescription, please?
Honorable mention.
Drive Angry. This one doesn't quite make the list for a couple of reasons. Number one, while it is one of the few examples of 3D serving a purpose, unfortunately that experience doesn't quite transfer upon home viewing. The second reason being that, well, William Fichtner does sort of run away with the film. Now, having said that, there is a scene in this film in which Nicolas Cage has sex with a woman while fully clothed, with sunglasses on, a fat cigar in his mouth, a bottle of Jack in one hand, and a gun in the other. If that wasn't enough for you, a bunch of goons break in and he proceeds to kill them all whilst never pulling out. When one of the goons grabs a taser and electrifies him, he starts vibrating and the woman on his penis orgasms, as do we, the rest of the audience, from the sheer awesomeness of the scene that we have just witnessed. When it comes to women's pleasure, the rabbit has nothing on an electrified Nicolas Cage.
Just so you know, I don't pick up hitchhikers.
I didn't have my thumb out.
Number 5.
Bad Lieutenant, Port of Call, New Orleans. In this movie, Nicolas Cage plays a drug addict cop, taking some names, kicking some ass, and hallucinating some iguanas. As with many of his best performances, this movie is really just Cage slowly going insane for 2 straight hours. Unfortunately, there are some lengthy pauses between these outbursts, but having said that, when they do occur, they are so brilliant that it easily secures this movie's place at number 5.
Shoot him again.
What for?
His soul's still dancing.
Number 4.
Con Air. Nicolas Cage plays a convict on his way home after serving time in prison. But the plane he is on is soon overtaken by the other criminals. The accent is awesome. The music is awesome. The Steve Buscemi is awesome. As a very good friend of mine once put it, they're cons, and they're in the air. What more do you need?
Put the bunny back in the box.
Number 3,
The Wicker Man. Now, this film is notoriously awful, so much so that if you're watching this video, you probably don't need me to tell you about it. It fails as a thriller. It fails as a horror. It fails to tell an interesting story with interesting characters. Where it succeeds, however, is in delivering some of the funniest Nick Cage moments ever recorded on film. It's almost as if, halfway through shooting, he realized, hey, I'm in a piece of shit. Well, fuck it. Might as well have some fun. Roundhouse kicking Amish women in the face, hijacking bicycles, screaming over burnt children's toys.
How to get burned!
In fact, I propose a challenge. Go on YouTube. Search for Nicolas Cage in a bear suit punches a woman in the face. Watch the video. I dare you not to laugh. Try it. It can't be done. What more can I say? Except, bring on the bees.
Oh, no, not the bees! Not the bees! Ah! Out of my eyes! Eyes! Ah! Ah!
Number 2.
Adaptation. Out of all the movies on this list, this is the one I would consider to be the, technically, best. Some people think it's too slow, but I disagree. It has great characters, an interesting story, and, well, Nick Cage in his Oscar mode, not just his crazy mode. But that is not why it ranks so highly. The reason for that is, well, in this film, you get twice the Nick Cage. That's right. Nicolas Cage plays both Charlie Kaufman and his fictional twin brother, Donald Kaufman. You get double the dose of Nick Cage in one single movie. Beyond that simple math, however, the performances are brilliant. Charlie Kaufman is nervous, always sweating, no confidence, whereas Donald Kaufman has all this charisma. He's the type of guy you'd look at and say, man, I'd really like to have a beer with that guy. Cage nails both performances, and in fact, he is so good, it's hard to imagine what could possibly top it.
What's Jesus and Einstein? Imagine me and you. I do. Come on. I think about you day and night. It's only right. Come on, sing with me. To think about the one you love and hold her tight. So happy together.
What the hell do you need binoculars?
Number 1.
Vampire's Kiss. What could possibly be better than two Nick Cages? Well, how about Nick Cage as a New York publisher who starts hallucinating and believes he's turning into a vampire?
Well.
Now, I'd never seen this movie before. I only watched it recently in forming this list. And let me tell you, I was on the floor, clutching my sides in laughter. This is the craziest I have ever seen Nick Cage. He goes absolutely batshit insane. Forgive the pun. Jumping on desks, berating his secretary, walking around with a steak, speaking with a British accent, but only when he wants to sound smart. Speaking to walls, eating cockroaches, reciting the alphabet, buying a pair of plastic vampire teeth, and biting a woman to death in a nightclub. There are so many fantastic scenes in this movie, I struggle to pick one for my final clip. Ultimately, I went with what follows, because I think it best exemplifies just how courageous Nick Cage is as an actor.
You're the lowest on the totem pole here, Alva. The lowest. Do you realize that? Every other secretary who's been here has been here longer than you, Alva. Everyone. And even if there was someone here who was here just one day longer than you, I still wouldn't ask that person to partake in such a miserable job as long as you were around. That's right, Alva. It's a horrible, horrible job, sifting through old contract after old contract. I couldn't think of a more horrible job if I wanted to. And you have to do it. You have to, or I'll fire you. Do you understand?
Well, that was my top five Nick Cagiest Nick Cage films. If you haven't seen them, or you just have a hankering for some Cage, be sure to check them out. And stay tuned for when I reveal my second actor choice. Until next time, folks.
And Nicolas Cage as Fu Manchu.
This is my mission!